بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حامدا ومصليا وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In today's lesson on Balaagha, we're moving on to the next chapter about non-informative sentences, and we'll start by talking about expressions of hope and desire. As you probably know, Arabic sentences can be divided into informative and non-informative sentences. An informative sentence is one in which information is being conveyed, like "I'm going for a walk." We call this a jumla khabariya. A non-informative sentence is one in which information is not being conveyed. These are things like questions, commands, emotional expressions, and so on. Like if I said, "Can I go for a walk?" I'm not trying to inform you of anything here. I'm just asking a question, even if you did happen to get some information out of it. We call this a jumla insha'iyya. There's a simple test that can tell you whether a sentence is informative or non-informative. Informative sentences have true and false, while non-informative sentences don't. For example, when I say I'm going for a walk, you can actually say, "Yeah, that's true," or "No, that's a lie." So you know this is an informative sentence. But when I give a command like "go to the park," or I ask a question like "can I go to the park?" you can't say "that's true" or "that's a lie." You see, it doesn't make sense. So you know this is a non-informative sentence. There are several types of non-informative sentences, some we already mentioned, like questions, commands, and emotional expressions. And there are others as well, like when you call someone, "Hey Khalid," or when you wish for something, "I wish I didn't have to go." And there are more. In Balaagha, we divide non-informative sentences into two major categories. The first is those types of sentences in which something is being sought or requested. These are called talabi. And the second is those in which something is not being sought or requested. These are called ghair talabi. Talabi sentences are the focus of Balaagha, and there are four types of jumla insha'iyya that we discuss under the umbrella of talabi: wishes, questions, commands, and calls. Wishes are talabi because when you wish for something, you seek the thing you wish for. Questions are talabi because when you ask a question, you seek an answer. Commands are talabi because when you command someone, you seek for an action to be completed or enacted. And calls are talabi because when you call someone, you seek their attention. Today we focus on wishes. In Arabic, this is called Tamanni. Tamanni is where you express desire for something either impossible or at least extremely unlikely. And the most common word for this in Arabic is Layta. For example, you would say Layta shababa ya'ud. I wish I could be young again. Or if you want, if only I could be young again. Or alternatively, if you want, would that I could be young again. Notice that becoming young again is impossible. Another expression of desire in Arabic is called taraji. Taraji is where you express desire for something that is either unlikely or likely, but not impossible. In English, we refer to this more commonly not as wishing, but as hoping. And the most common word for this in Arabic is la'alla. For example, la'allahu yazuruni. I hope he visits me. Notice that someone visiting you is well within reason. It's not impossible. The word la'alla can actually be used for both tamanni and taraji. So now we have two words we can use for tamanni. A third word for expressing tamanni is hal. Notice that hal is typically used in questions, like when Jahannam asks Allah Azza wa Jal, "Hal min mazid?" Are there any more? But it can also be used for wishing, like when the disbeliever will say on the Day of Judgment, "Hal li min shafir?" Is there no intercessor for me? So he knows there is no intercessor for him, but he wishes beyond all hope that there would be. Now the reason he uses hal as opposed to layta in the context of tamanni, wishing, is for the very reason that hal is used for questions. You see, when you have tamanni for something, you know that thing is impossible, or at least extremely unlikely, like the example of youth returning. But when you ask a question, you don't know which way it'll go. That's why you're asking the question. Both are possible. So by using a question word in the place of a wish, the disbeliever is pretending there's some hope for him, and this shows his complete desperation, and to find any inkling of hope that there may be. In Arabic, we call this reducing the impossible to the level of the possible, and the purpose is to show complete and utter desperation. A fourth word for expressing tamanni is law. Notice that law is typically a conditional, similar to the English word had, H-A-D. For example, لو أتيتني لأكرمتك. Had you come to me, I would have honored you. It can also be used for wishing. For example, someone might wish to visit the Prophet ﷺ's grave, and they would say, "Lo ahujju fa azuraka." If only I could somehow do Hajj so I could visit you. When lo is used in this way, the jawab of lo must be preceded by a fa. Fa azuruka. Fa azuraka. The reason lo is used in the context of wishing and hoping is because in its conditional form, it conveys the non-occurrence of something in the past. You see, when I say, had you visited me, obviously the understanding is that you didn't visit me. And the non-occurrence of something in the past is the strongest form of impossibility. So the word that's used in the context of the strongest form of impossibility is also used in the context of tamanni, to show that the thing I'm wishing for is way beyond anything I could have ever hoped for.